Hi everyone, today on 3D Revolution, I'm going to be looking at Rigid Ink's Floss Filament. If you're constantly changing between different types of filament in your printer, especially those which print at a different temperature, you've probably at some point or other had a clogged nozzle. Regardless of how careful you are when you change your filaments, there's always a chance that something has been left behind in the hot end or the extruder, and when it comes to printing, these can cause real issues. If the last filament you used required a higher temperature than your new one, particles left over in your hot end would remain solid and can completely block your nozzle. On the other hand, if the last filament you used required a lower temperature than your new one, particles left over in your hot end may burn, ruining your print, or worse. At the start of the year, Rigid Ink released their filament floss, and after a particularly bad nozzle cloggage, I decided to jump straight on board and order myself a reel. When it arrived, however, I was a bit taken aback about how small it was. £15 for 50 grams doesn't seem like it's tremendous value, but when you start looking at how much you actually use, it starts to make a bit more sense. Now, the filament floss works because of two key properties. Firstly, it has a huge temperature range. This thing can print from 170 all the way through to 280 degrees and over, and it's highly adhesive. This makes it perfect for picking up those small, high-temperature filament particles. And if anything's left from this filament after the process, it'll come out clean in your low-temperature filament. I've found that to get the best results, heat your extruder up to 5 degrees hotter than the highest temperature you've printed with so far. Cut 20 to 30 centimeters of filament and simply extrude it through the hot end at either a medium speed or whatever your printer's default loading speed is. Once it starts to come through, you'll see it taking on a white spiral shape, and you should be able to notice small particles of your older filament lodged within. I've been using this cleaner floss for about 8 months now, and in that time I haven't had a single clogged nozzle. I've also found that the reel itself hasn't really reduced in size. It's still not that much smaller than when I got it, mainly because you don't need to use that much. It may be that it doesn't work for everyone. It may be that your printer just doesn't need it, or that you're better at changing filaments than me. Either way, I would thoroughly suggest this to anyone that is having clogged nozzle issues as a result of their changing through different filaments. I think considering how much I've got left, it's great value for £15, so let me know what you think in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and remember, hit subscribe for more news, tips, and live streams on everything 3D and tech.